Technically, she didn't have to even show up to leave a big impression. I mean, come on. This massive mural has been doing that for her since it was painted back in August. Now, yesterday, though, Rapinoe arranged a quick visit in secret to thank the painter and the owner of the bar who came up with this artwork. And everyone involved told me the significance of it all is even bigger than this.
For a few months now, the mural of Megan Rapinoe, just a block from Allianz Field, has been a trendy photo stop. And it's now trending, thanks to a visit from the women's national team star herself.
She's one of my favorite players, and she posted about it last night. I didn't know it was a thing, so I was like, I gotta go see it and take a picture with it now.
This is selfishly about me getting to meet Megan.
Wes Burdine is the owner of Blackheart St. Paul and says he really did dedicate a side of his building with that larger goal in mind.
I knew that if you're in town and there's a gigantic mural of you, it's pretty hard to not go visit it.
Wes is like opening up personal boxes for me. I'm like, am I that? Yeah, definitely. If there's something this big of me, I'm likely gonna wanna see it. Particularly if it's on the side of a gay bar and a soccer bar at that.
In reality, that last part, the significance of this place, that's why this mural and this photo op are more than that for both Megan and Wes.
Blackheart of St. Paul is a queer soccer bar, and someone like Megan, who has been so forceful in advocating for others and using soccer as something more than just a game, she's a hero to people like me, to soccer fans, and to our patrons.
It's so humbling, to be honest. I think, you know, gay bars and trans bars and lesbian bars all over the country and the world, those are sacred and sort of safe and just incredible places. And to have it be this beautiful mural, this beautiful piece of artwork, which, you know, sort of speaks for the culture in a lot of ways, sports in a lot of ways, is very special to me and something that I always remember.
She also made sure everyone else will remember it too, leaving her mark on the mural itself.
I know you've signed a lot of autographs in your day. Have you ever signed a building?
I have not. None nearly as cool as that. To actually be able to have the artist teach me a little bit, give me a few tips, and then actually to, you know, tag this beautiful piece of artwork. And it actually turned out okay. I was kind of afraid of like totally messing up, so I wanted to nail it so I didn't completely mess up this beautiful work of art. But yeah, happy I could get my little tag on there, and now I can say I'm a, you know, graffiti artist.
If true, Wes is now the proud owner of her first autographed paint can in her signature purple shade, along with a couple of outtakes that will be on display soon inside the bar.
Any chance she's gonna stop by after the match?
No. COVID protocols means that she won't join karaoke after the game, but she's promised us that next time she's through town, she's going to come to a drag show and sing karaoke with us.
Once we're in a safer place with COVID, definitely the next time we're in town, I feel like I owe him a tequila shot or something. Stop in, see a show, and enjoy that place. It looks like an incredible bar.
Keep an eye out. During her visit, Rapinoe also praised the founders of the upcoming Minnesota professional women's soccer team, and she alluded to the fact that she also spoke to Rock Martinez, the artist who painted all of this. He just likes to keep a low profile. As far as Megan's art, Wes says it won't just be on display at the bar. He's donating one of the cardboard tags to an upcoming charity auction put on by Dark Clouds, the Minnesota United supporters group. Jana.
That's all pretty cool. You know, the pressure of a penalty kick and, I don't know, like the World Cup finals might be more than tagging that building, but maybe not.
Yeah.
When do they play tomorrow? The women play tomorrow night in a significant game, right?
Yeah, they've got a friendly tomorrow against South Korea, 7 o'clock. They'll be out there.
All right. Thanks so much, Kent.